हे फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू चैनल टेक टॉक्स। आई एम संपदा कुलकर्णी एंड हियर टू एक्सप्लेन यू द सीरीज ऑफ सर्कुलर क्यू डेटा स्ट्रक्चर। टिल नाउ वी हैव गॉन थ्रू मेनी ऑफ द टॉपिक्स लाइक व्हाई सर्कुलर क्यू, इंट्रोडक्शन टू सर्कुलर क्यू, फीचर्स ऑफ इट, हाउ सी क्यू वर्क्स, हाउ इट ऑपरेट्स। Then I have explained the insertion operation, deletion operation separately and combinedly as well. And my previous video was about insert function in C++, how to write down insert function in C++. In line with the same, now I am explaining you the next video of this video series. It's to explain how to write down the delete function in C++. So friends, if you have not subscribe to my channel Tech Talks, then please subscribe it and keep the bell ringing. Now let's start with the operations on circular queue, where I am focusing on the delete function in C++. So which operations we can perform on a circular queue, friends? Yes, you are right. So the first operation we can perform is nothing but insert or NQ operation. And for that, which condition we supposed to check? We supposed to check the condition of is overflow or is full. We have seen all these things in previous video. For you, I am providing you a shortcut key in this right up corner. You just go through that if you are not knowing the concept about NQ operation or the insert operation on circular queue. Now here I am focusing on delete operation. It is also called as DQ operation, and for that, which condition we supposed to check, dear friends? Yes, we supposed to check is empty condition or is underflow condition. So among these two operations, let's focus on the deletion operation. So dear friends, let's start with the deletion algorithm. What I will do, I'll explain you the algorithm step by step. And in line with that algorithm, I'll explain you the line of code that you can write down in C++ simultaneously. So what is my first step in this deletion algorithm? The first step is to check whether my queue is empty or not. Friends, if my queue is empty, what does it mean? It means that my front pointer is pointing at -1 position. What does it indicate? Other way around, it indicates that if my front is at -1 position, it means that my queue is empty. If it is yes, then what you have to do? You have to display the message CQ is empty and you supposed to exit from the function. So first of all, let's perform this step in C++ programming language. So let's start, dear friends. So this is the function to perform DQ operation, that is to remove data from the queue or to delete data from the circular queue. So here I have written the function DQ whose return type is integer. Why the return type is integer? Because whatever the number, whatever the element, whatever the value we are deleting from the circular queue, that we are returning back from this function to the main function. So that's why its return type is integer. So now here you can think like that my circular queue is of type integer, because it holds the integer type of values. What is my next statement? My next statement is nothing but I am declaring one variable y. Now let's check whether my queue is empty. This is my first step. Now whenever you are going to call this function, your control will move from this DQ function to the isEmpty function. You just look here where I have written a function to check whether queue is empty or not. Its return type is boolean. Why it should be boolean? Because it returns either a value true or false. If your circular queue is empty, the function will return true value. If your circular queue is non-empty, then it will return the false value. So what we have to write down in this isEmpty function? So first of all, you supposed to check where is the position of front pointer. If front is at -1 position, what does it indicate? It indicates that my Q is empty, and that's why we supposed to return a true value from this function. Now let's consider that my Q is empty, the condition is true, and if this condition is true, this return statement will get executed and it will return from is empty function to the DQ function and to the next line from where we have made call to this is empty function. So this true value will get replaced with this is empty function call, and this condition is going to become true. If true, then it enters into the if condition and it displays the message Q is empty. And this was our first step. So I hope that you have understood the step number 1. Now let's move to the next step. What we have done, if this condition is true, what we have to do? I have explained just now. But what is the case if front is not pointing to minus 1? It indicates that the Q is not empty. Means what? The else condition or the false condition. In case of no, if the Q is not empty, in case of false condition, what we have to do? We have to go forward for the step number 2. So the step number 2 is nothing but to check whether circular Q is holding single element or not. How are you going to identify the single element, and how or why we supposed to check whether it is holding a single element? Let's elaborate this thing, why we are checking this single element. Because after performing the deletion operation, whatever the single element was there present in a circular queue is get deleted. It means that your circular queue is going to form an empty queue after deletion of that element. So that's why we have to take care of this single element. Now you must have understood that why to identify the single element, but now how to identify the single element? For that we have to check a condition, that is whether my front and rear are at the same position. We don't have to bother about the position, means at which position the front and rear are. That may be at the 0th position, 1st position, 2nd position, or any of the position. We can say a valid position till max minus 1. Let's consider the max. Max is the highest limit of your circular queue. So any of the position, but if both front and rear are at the same position, it indicates that the queue is holding a single element. And if queue is holding a single element, that is if this condition is true, what we have to do? We have to return or delete the front item, front element, whatever which is present at the front position, and we supposed to reinitialize both front and rear to minus 1 position, as I explained previously. Because after deletion of the element, Q is going to become empty, and to indicate that Q is empty, our front and rear both should be at minus 1 position. So we will perform these operations if my front and rear are at the same position, means a single element is present. Now let's move to our program. Till this statement we have done in the previous half of this video. Now let's move forward. That is, if this condition is false, that is front is not equal to minus 1, it indicates that the element are present in our queue. So that's why it will go into the else part, and after that in this else we will return a false value because my queue is not empty. In this case, this first half will not get executed. It will go into the else part and it will return the false as a boolean value. Now here, this if is going to become false. So that's why it will go to the next statement, that is into the else part. And in this else part, what we have written? We have whatever the value which was present at the front, that we are taking its copy into the variable y. And after that we have to do that only one element was in a queue, so that's why we have to reset the position of front and rear after removal of that element. So now we have to check whether front and rear are equal to or at the same position. It indicates that a single element is present, and if this condition is true, it indicates that we have to reposition the front and rear to minus 1. This was the second step of the deletion algorithm. And now After that, we have to return back the element y to the main function to indicate that this was the deleted value. Now let's move to the next part. Let's consider the queue is not holding a single element. Okay, we have seen that if the single element is present, what we have to do. Now let's see if the single element is not present, means if this condition is false. It means that both front and rear are not at the same position, then what we have to do. So if a single element is not present, then what we have to do, we have to move forward to the step number 3. In step number 3, we have to perform the circular increment. On which we have to perform a circular increment? On the front pointer. Why onto the front pointer? Because we are performing the deletion operation, and to perform delete operation, we supposed to increment the front pointer. Or other way round, we can say that the deletion operation can be performed on the front position, front pointer of a circular queue. What is the formula to perform circular increment? I have explained this formula in detail in my previous videos. Still, I am explaining you this in short. It's nothing but if I want to perform circular increment, then I will use the modulo operator. And now let's consider that my queue size is nothing but 10. So that's why modulo division by the size of the queue. And what I will do, I will go forward for the front plus 1 and then modulo division by 10. Whatever the remainder will be there, that is nothing but my updated front. And with this, I can perform the circular increment in the front pointer. After circular increment, what I have to do? I have to go forward for the step number 4, and where in the step number 4, we can delete the element, and that we have to initialize to the variable. And these steps I am going to explain you with the help of program. Now what we have seen, now we have seen that if the single element is there, what we have to do, but if it is not, it will go into the else part. Okay friends, so it will go into the else part, and in else part what we have to do, we have to perform the circular increment. And here we have performed the circular increment by modulo division by size of the queue. After that, what I have to do, I have to return the y value which we have already collected, which was the present in a front position, that we have collected into y, and that we are returning to the main function. So in this way, we can perform the delete or the dequeue operation on a circular queue. So thank you dear friends for listening and watching my video. If you like the video and its contents, please do not forget to give the comment, as well as you can subscribe my channel. Here I am providing you a subscription link. Along with this, I am providing you a shortcut link for the next video of this video series, and a whole video series also I am here providing you for your reference in the form of playlist. So thank you friends. Happy data structuring, happy learning. Thank you.